motion would first die, then to let us go. That he would lay his life down for us. That he would lay his life.
Sunday. 现，唯有你配得所有赞美。我只想要歌唱，用我全心来颂扬，只为你我的君王。哦，人或许不明白，为何我唱这么嗨，你配得最高清白。哦，哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦
哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦
哦哦哦哦哦哦
哦哦哦哦
哦哦哦哦
哦哦哦哦哦哦
哦哦哦哦
哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦
哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦
哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦哦
弟兄姐妹们，我们欢迎大家回家。今天我们要来赞美我们的神，今天是我们的主日。我想在还没开始之前，我要以诗篇28:6来宣告神的同在。耶和华是应当称颂的，因为他听了我恳求的声音。耶和华是我的力量，是我的盾牌，我心里依靠他就得帮助，所以我心中欢乐，我必用诗歌来歌颂他。
Welcome home everyone. Before we start, let's proclaim Psalms 28 verse 5-7. Praise be to the Lord, for he has heard my cry for mercy. My Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusts in him and he helps me. My heart leaps for joy and with my song I praise him.
感谢主，阿爸天父，我感谢你。主啊，我们要歌颂你，我们要赞美你。主啊，我们知道，主啊，你是我们的神。主啊，我们应当称谢来进入他的门，当赞美进入他的宴，当感谢他，称颂他的名。主啊，我们高举你的名字。主啊，恳求来祝福今天的敬拜赞美。主啊，我们感谢你，奉主耶稣基督的名求。
Let's pray for today's service. Know that the Lord is God. It is He who made us, and we are His. We are His people, the sheep of His pasture.Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. For the Lord is good and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations. We place today's service into your hands.
Amen.
Amen.
我们一起来敬拜，阿门。
Let's proceed into today's praise and worship.
Amen. 欢迎弟兄姐妹们来到我们的现场。好不好？你在你的荧幕前面，你给你的身边、你的家人，给他一个的 high five， 说。我们的神是蛮有盼望的神，他也要将喜乐赐给你 ，Amen。让我们就用这个的诗篇100篇来敬拜赞美我们的神。
普天下大响耶和华欢呼，你们当雷释奉耶和华，当来向他歌唱。当来向他歌唱，你们当晓得耶和华是神，我们是他造，也是属他的，我们是他的民，是他草场的羊。当称谢进入他的门，当赞美进入他的院，当感谢他。称颂他的名，因为耶和华本为善，他的慈爱存到永远，他的心事直到万代。
阿门。我们一起来拍掌，敬拜赞美我们的主。
普天下当向耶和华欢呼，你们当乐意侍奉耶和华，当来向他歌唱，当来向他歌唱。你们当晓得耶和华是神，我们是他造，也是属他的，我们是他的民，是他草场的羊。当称谢进入他的门，当赞美进入他的院，当感谢他，称颂他的名，因为耶和华本为善，他的慈爱存到永远，他的心事直到。
让我们用称谢归给我们的主。
当称谢进入他的门，当赞美进入他的院，
当感谢他，
当感谢他，称颂他的名，因为耶和华本为善，他的慈爱存到永远，他的心事直到万代，
他的心事。
神他的心事直到万代，
神你是配得我们的敬拜。
他的心事直到万代，
哈利路亚， 一切荣耀的赞美的归给我们的神，因为唯有你才配得我们去敬拜你。哈利路亚，是的，感谢你，是的，神。所以我们知道在那的动荡当中，但我们依然的把我们的眼目定睛于你。所以我们知道，因为一切的得胜都在你的身上，万物的本于你，归于你。是的，主，
基督是我奖赏，是我唯一所爱慕，这世上没有事物能够带给我满足，在失恋中我领歌唱，永不回头，我的自由，基督是我满足，基督你是我心，一切所需在于你，哦，一切在于你，基督我全所有，就温习了在于你。
是的，神，我们知道我们有这个盼望，
这盼望永不止息，天堂是我家，暴风雨中我领歌唱，与你同行，荣耀归给上帝，基督是我满足，一切在于是的时候，我们宣告你就是我们的满足，基督是我满足，基督你是我心满足，我一切所需在于你，一切在，让我们一起来宣告，暴风雨中我领歌，暴风雨中，暴风雨中我领，是的，我们仰望你，暴风，暴风雨中我领歌唱，与你同行，荣耀归给上帝， 所需在于你，一切在于你，基督是我满足，基督你是我心满足，我一切所需在于你，一切在于你。
神就支持我们的决定。
我一起要跟随你，要跟随耶稣，永不回头，永不
十架在前面，
十架在前面，世界在背后，永不回头，永不回头，十架在前面。
我们永远不回头，
永不回头，永不回头，永不回头，永不回头。
是的，耶稣，我们感谢赞美你，感谢你悦纳我们的敬拜，孩子完全的将以下。让我们来打开我们的心，准备我们的耳朵，让我们来聆听神你的话语，让我们来吸收神你的话语。孩子完全的将以下的时间交托，祷告乃是奉靠耶稣基督的圣名祈求， Amen。 祝福每位。
大家好，我是来自 PK 堂的蔡思华。在2019年呢，是我最后一年上大学了，所以即将毕业的我就开始我的计划，就是想要找一份的工作。我还记得那一年的年尾，我交上了 FYP 过后呢，我就得知了一个消息，就是说有一间的学校想要请一位的老师。我听到这个的消息过后呢，我没有做出任何的决定，是因为对我而言这个是很大的挑战。但是因着家人还有朋友鼓励之下呢，我就鼓起了勇气，我就去申请了。在就是去这学校的路途中，我就祷告，就把这件事情我都交托给神。当然我的家人也是为我祷告，所以感谢神的是，就是在整个的过程中都是顺利的。然后那一天我也知道一个的事情，就是说在很多的应征者中呢，他们都很厉害，然后而我呢就是完全就是一位新鲜出炉的新人，所以我心想说就是我应该不会得到这个的工作。所以在我回去 OK 等待消息的时候，学校就打来了，然后非常之感谢神，就是我得到了这个的工作，就是我被录取了。所以神给了我这份完全意想不到的礼物。在2020年，我就问神，我就说，哎，神，为什么你会给我这一份的礼物呢？所以我也没有想多，就这样我就打了一年的工作。所以我记得的是，在12月20日，神就回应了我这一个的问题。他就是告诉我说，他知道我们过去，也知道我们未来的事。然后我们所有的事情都是在他的手中，所以他按照了他的时间给了我这一份的礼物。就是这样，在我再一次的回去，就是回想在2019年的我，我不知道2020年所发生的事情，但是神却按照他的时间给了我这一份的礼物，好让我在2020年不会因着生活，不会因着各方面的事情而担忧。所以他真的是一位真实然后信实的神。然后他再一次的告诉我说，他所给的应许都是 yes and amen 的，所以我想要把这一切的荣耀都是归给神，他真的是配得这一份的荣耀。
耶，弟兄姐妹，欢迎回家， welcome home。正如刚刚我们所唱的那一首歌一样，基督是我们心中的满足， Christ is enough for me， amen。同样的，我们除了用歌声来敬拜，我们也要用我们的钱财来敬拜我们的神。好吧，我们今天看一个的经节，大家都非常熟悉的，就是路加福音的12章34节。路加福音12章34节，因为你的财宝在哪里，你的心也在那里。好吧，我们再读一次，因为你的财宝在哪里，你的心也在那里。弟兄姐妹，我们每一次的这一个的奉献，我们都要提醒我们的心要在耶稣基督里，因为一切的满足都在耶稣基督里， Amen。 我们不只是一个例行公事的奉献，而每一次我们都要操练，我们都要提醒我们自己，我们的心在耶稣基督里，因为一切的满足都在他里面， Amen。 好不好，接下来你们就看你们所看到的这一个的银行户头，
你们就可以透过这个的线上的转账，将你们的奉献转账至这一个的户头当中。当然也请记得注明你们所属的堂会。 OK， 好，当然也在这里也要提醒大家，就是在2月6日跟2月7日的线上主日当中，我们一如往常每个月的第一个礼拜，我们都会一起的分享这一个的圣餐。所以提醒弟兄姐妹们，在聚会开始之前就请准备好你们的饼干以及葡萄汁，当牧师给出这一带领大家分享这一个的圣餐的时候，我们就可以一同的分享圣餐。好，而且在2月6日跟2月7日将会是我们的李文婷师母来向我们分享神的话语，她的主题是真的不假，假的不真。好吧，我们就一起参与这一个的线上主日，来聆听师母所要对我们说的神的话语。 Amen。 好，这个时候我们就把时间交给我们今天的讲员， Let's go。
弟兄姐妹们平安，奉主耶稣基督的名祝福你们。
Shalom brothers and sisters, we bless you in the name of Jesus.
今天我们再看跨越世代的界限。
Today we will look at the theme of crossing the generation line.
今天跟大家分享的信息主题是希望下一代还有希望。
So the topic of today's sermon is let's hope there's still hope in the next generation.
这个题目听起来有点的绕舌，有点的复杂。
It sounds complicated.
本来我想用一个比较直接，一个比较积极的一个的题目。
Initially, I wanted to take a more positive topic.
比如说，下一代肯定有希望。
So it sounds probably like there will surely be hope in the next generation.
但是我不想给大家一个的错误的盼望。
But I do not want to give you the false hope.
因为如果我们没有觉醒，没有做好预备呢，我们很有可能真的会失去下一代的希望。
Because if we do not come to realization and grab hope at the moment, we will probably lose hope for the next generation.
那我们先来祷告。
Let us all pray.
亲爱的主耶稣，我们求你真理的灵来光照我们，启发我们。
Dear Lord Jesus, may your spirit of truth enlighten us.
叫我们明白你的话语。
Help us to understand your word.
祷告奉主耶稣基督的名。
In the name of Jesus, we pray.
我们先来稍微温习一下上一篇所分享的信息。
Now let us revise some of the main points from previous sermon.
好，上一篇我们在但以理书的第一章，我们看到巴比伦王尼布加尼撒就掳掠了一群犹大的少年回到巴比伦去。
So in Daniel first chapter, so the king Nebuchadnezzar actually taken some of the Israelites youth into exile.
好，就是要把他们留在王宫里服侍。
And they captured them to serve him in the palace.
我们看到巴比伦的改造体系。
So we have seen the revolution of the Babylonian system.
就好像今天的极权的主义，他们的改造再教育的制度。
It's just like today's system whereby they try to change the education culture.
他们就是以优秀的少年人为改造洗脑的目标。
So the first point is they focus on indoctrinating and brainwashing the elite young people.
巴比伦王他不只是掠夺了圣殿的一些的器具。
The Babylonian king did not just rob away some of the utensils in the holy temple.
他要打击犹太人对他们神的信心。
He wanted to challenge the faith of the Israelites to their God.
然后他也掳掠了犹太人的希望。
They have also captivated the Israelites' hope.
就是他们的将来，他专注在那些优秀的、那些聪明的、那些精英的新生代。
So their focus was on the elite young people.
把他们掳回巴比伦，然后在这个王宫里面训练他们三年，留在王宫服侍。
So to capture them in the palace and have them to serve him for 3 years in the palace.
他要使犹太人失去下一代的希望。
He wanted the next generation of Israelites to lose hope.
然后我们看到第二点呢，他就是以文字语言改变这些少年人他们的思维与文化。
And we also saw he tried to transform their mind and culture with literature and language.
这些犹大的少年人，如果他们要在巴比伦生存，要在那里工作，他们就必须要学习巴比伦的语言文化。
So, these Israelites youth, if they were to work in Babylonia, they have to learn their language and their culture.
但是如果他们对自己本身的希伯来的文化跟信仰不扎实的话，那么就意味着他们渐渐的去忘记他们的文化，他们就与他们的神脱离了关系。
So if they are not rooted well enough in their Hebrew language and faith, then they will slowly drift away from their faith in God.
然后他们就很容易的被完全同化了。
And they will fully be assimilated.
然后第三点，我们看到他以诱人的供应和特别的优待作为他们的依赖。
And the third point, he offers them provision with special privileges to get their dependency.
巴比伦王每日供应他们王的膳食和酒菜。
So the Babylonian king actually provided them a choicest food.
这是上等的待遇，这是非常尊荣的一个的款待。
This is a very honorable hospitality.
这是叫他们不能够拒绝的一些的条件，如果他们拒绝了，反而会得罪了这个巴比伦王。
So these privileges are actually very hard for them to reject, and if they reject them, they are actually offending the king.
然后最后呢，他是以新的名字、身份去切断他们的过去。
And finally, he gave them new names and identities to cut ties with their past.
给他们新的名字呢，就是取代他们旧的名字，赋予他们一个新的名字、新的身份、新的文化。
So giving them new name, meaning helping them to remove their previous identity so that they can be assimilated to their culture.
提供他们每日的膳食，每日的供应。
Providing them the daily food and drinks.
把他们重新的再教育。
To re-educate them.
那个目的就是要完全的去改造他们。
The purpose is to fully transform them.
要切断他们与他们过去的文化、他们的信仰、他们与神的关系。
And to cut the ties with their past and their God.
把他们完全的融入巴比伦的文化的当中。
And to fully assimilate them into the Babylonian culture.
今天撒旦也是用同样的世界的方式来得着，来同化我们的新生代。
Today, Satan uses similar ways to assimilate our young generation.
他要赋予他们符合世界的名称、身份。
He wants to give them identity and names that belong to the world.
他要用这个物质的供应来满足他们的需要，他们的这个要求。
And give them material provision to satisfy.
得着他们的依赖。
To obtain their dependence.
他用世界的文化、大众传媒等等的信息去改变他们的思维。
So using the worldly culture like social media to transform their minds.
如果今天父母亲不管是肉身或者是属灵的父母亲，我们没有好好的预备我们的下一代。
So whether or not we are biological or spiritual parents, if we do not prepare our young generation well,
我们没有与这个生命的产业遗留给他们。
If we do not give them inheritance of life,
就是我提过的给他们金钱的生命。
Meaning giving them godliness,
有聪慧的生命。
A wise life,
健康的人生。
And a healthy life,
还有富足的人生。
And also a wealthy and abundant life.
那么世界的王呢，就会以另类的方式，就是类似却完全相反的方式来取代。
So the king of the world will then use a similar but totally opposite culture to actually attract them.
我们有充分的理由相信，为什么但以理和他的三个朋友如此的与众不同呢？
So we have all the reasons to believe why Daniel and his three friends were outstanding.
我们相信他们在背后必然有非常敬畏神的父母。
So we believe behind them there are parents who were God.
从小就以神的话语去教导他们，预备他们。
Teaching and equipping them with the word of God from young.
而且他们有很强的危机意识。
And they have a sense of threat.
在这些少年人还没有被掳到巴比伦之前，他们已经做好了预备。
Before these young people were captivated by the Babylonian king, they were already well prepared.
今天我们再接下去看第八节。
Today, let us continue to look at verse 8.
这里说，但以理立志不与王的膳和王所饮的酒玷污自己，所以求太监长容他不玷污自己。
But Daniel purposed in his heart that he would not defile himself with a portion of the king's delicacies, nor with the wine which he drank. Therefore, he requested of the chief of the eunuchs that he might not defile himself.
王的膳食，意思王所吃用的酒菜，肯定是不会肮脏、不卫生的。
King's delicacies here meaning food and drinks which are not clean.
意思说不会肮脏的，就是不会、不卫生的。
Yeah, it means that it will not be not clean. It will be clean.
但是为什么会玷污他们呢？
But how come such a clean food will actually defile them?
这是指属灵的含义。
So this actually has spiritual meaning.
因为巴比伦人吃的肉类是不符合当时犹太人所遵从的摩西的律法。
Because the meat that Babylonian take during that time actually doesn't fulfill the law of Moses.
而且也有很有可能是拜祭过偶像的。
And it is very likely that it has been sacrificed to idols.
如果他们吃了，就会玷污自己，得罪耶和华他们的神，然后呢，就是曲解了他们的信仰。
So if they have partaken the food, the meat, then in a way they have defiled their faith in God.
这就成为丹以理与巴比伦王的第一个的冲突。他到底要顺从神呢，还是要听从王？
So this has become the first conflict between Daniel and Babylonian king. So does he need to obey the king of Babylonian or his God?
你看，丹以理他们没有拒绝新的名字。
So Daniel did not reject their new names.
因为他们知道他们自己是谁，他们真正的身份。
Because they knew their true identity.
不管别人如何称呼他们。
No matter how people address them.
他们也没有拒绝接受巴比伦的文化和教育。
They did not reject education from the Babylonians.
因为他们知道他们相信的是谁，他们相信的是什么。
Because they believe in whom they believe in and who what they believe.
他们不会随意的盲从世界的文化。
They will not be blinded by the culture of the world.
但是这些食物却是直接的违背了律法，就是违背神的话。
But this food is directly defiling and disobeying the word of God.
今天我们在职场上，我们是否有可能坚守圣经的原则，不与世界同流合污？
So can we in this era still hold on to the biblical principles and not be drifted away by the worldly principles?
但同时之间，我们又可以避免与人冲突呢？
But at the same time, we maintain peace with everyone.
哦，但是这就必须要有从神而来的智慧和勇气了。
This then requires wisdom and courage from the Lord.
所以他们第一，他们需要的就是一个的跨越惧怕，进入勇敢的决心。
So they need a faith to cross into the courage.
所以他们要战胜他们的心中的惧怕，得到勇气，他们就必须要有心念，然后才会有做出决定。有了决定，才会做出行动。
So in order to cross from the fear to courage, they have to be convicted and they have to make the decision and put forth action.
他们必须要有很强的信念，相信呢，耶和华神依然掌权，他居首位。
So they have to have the strong conviction that God still reigns and He is still positioned as first.
他们宁愿得罪人也不得罪神，就是敬畏神过于惧怕人。
They honor God before more than man.
然后他就做出一个决定，就是立志不玷污自己。
And hence they were then driven to make the decision.
然后他有一个行动，就是求太监长不容他玷污自己。
And then pair with the action to ask the eunuchs not to defile themselves.
我们看到呢，他在心中立志做出一个决定。
So we have seen that they have decided in their heart.
立志就是定义，要顺服神，要接受考验，荣耀神胜过考验。
Which is the decision to honor God, no matter how many trials to overcome.
他心中已经决定了，不要不妥协。
They have decided not to compromise.
那他要做出一个选择。
Hence they made a decision, a choice.
如果吃，就玷污自己，得罪神。
If they take the food, then they will defile themselves and offend God.
不吃就得罪王，可能会引起很严重的后果。
So if they don't take the food, then they probably will offend the king and bring about negative consequences.
然后他们需要很大的勇气。
And they need huge courage.
不管他的决定或行动都是一个的冒险。
Whether it's the decision or their action, it's actually an act of risk.
小子会失去他的恩宠，就是不会失去他被提拔的机会。
If it's a minor consequence, probably they will lose the honor and favor from the king on promotion.
但是更严重的后果呢，可能就是面对很严厉的责罚，甚至是失去生命。
But a more serious consequence would be a punishment which is more severe and probably death.
你要知道这个的太监长啊，这个宫里的公公啊，他肯定是一个非常严格的人。
You should know that this head of eunuchs should be one that is very strict.
因为在这个太监公公的手下，有可能是几十个，或者是甚至是几百个少年人的奴隶。
So probably eunuchs are actually taking charge over tens or hundreds of slaves from Israel.
而且他要对这个的巴比伦王是一个非常残暴的王来负责。
And he has to be accountable to this Babylonian king who is very tyrant. Yeah.
如果他有什么的差错呢，他甚至也要赔上自己的生命。
So if there's anything that went wrong, he probably needed to pay the price of his life.
你看这个巴比伦王非常的残酷，当他掳去这个巴比伦这个犹大王的时候呢，就在他的面前把他所有的儿子都杀了。
So he was really cruel when he captivated the king of Judah. He actually killed all his children before his eyes.
然后就把他的眼睛挖掉。
And gouged away their eyeballs.
就是让这个王他一生的记忆就是他孩子被杀的情景。
So that this king he will then live with the memories of witnessing his own children's death.
所以我们知道这个的太监长呢，他肯定是一个也是非常严格的一个人。
So we should know that this head of eunuchs is one that is very strict.
他们需要非常大的勇气。
They needed a huge courage.
而且他决定不妥协。
And they decided not to compromise.
你看，离开了父母，离开了家人，离开了自己家乡的环境，是更容易的妥协的。
So as one leave their homeland or parents, it's actually in a new culture they are more easily compromised.、Actually.
你看其他的少年人，他们岂不都是妥协了吗？
So all the other young people have compromised.
人在江湖身不由己。
Oh, we are in this situation. There's no other choice.
每个人都在做，大家都在做，为什么我不能做？
So everyone is doing the same thing. Why can't I do it?
但是他们没有妥协。
But they did not compromise.
他们也没有埋怨神。
They did not complain to God.
他们没有说神啊，你都没有拦阻我们面对试探，面对考验。
They did not say, God, why did you not stop these trials from happening?
为什么我还要信靠你，还要顺服你呢？
Why do I still have to obey you and follow after you?
而且他们立志分别为圣。
But they decided and was convicted to consecrate themselves.
意思说接下来的三年他们只吃菜不吃肉。
Meaning in the coming 3 years, they only lived on vegetables and not meat.
你想想三年只吃菜不吃肉是多么的痛苦的事。
Imagine how painful it is just to take vegetables for 3 years without meat.
看到身边的人都大鱼大肉，牛扒羊扒叉烧烧肉。
Beef steak, char siu, or you know, roasted pork. Beside you, people are just taking all this food, but yet you can't take it.
但是他们却只能够吃蔬菜。
They could only take vegetables.
而且他们愿意付出代价。
They were willing to pay the price.
很有可能他们会失去恩宠。
They probably would lose their favor.
失去他们的名声。
Their reputation.
可能身边的人都会嘲笑他们，毁谤他们。
Or probably people around them would despise and ridicule them.
可能他们会失去身边的朋友，跟他们切割关系，不要连累我。
Probably they will have friends who draw away from them.
可能会失去自己的生命。
Probably they will lose their lives.
但是他们却愿意接受考验。
But they were willing to take up the challenge.
你看一个真正的基督徒，愿意让他自己的信心，他的信仰接受考验。
So when a Christian is willing to have their faith tested,
他们不像很多的政治家，只是一味的否认，但是却不愿意面对审核。
So many, just like many politicians, they are not willing to face the judgment.
而且他们也在小事上忠心。
They are also faithful on small things.
看起来是很小的事情，吃或不吃，但是对他们知道那个的意义是重大的。
Even though it looks like a small matter, but they know the greater meaning behind it.
这些奴隶的少年，他们有什么的资格来讨价还价呢？
So these captivated young people, what criteria or what condition do they have to negotiate with the eunuch?
他们竟敢拒绝王对他们的安排。
They actually were daring enough to reject the arrangement from the king.
他们好像是把这个小事要搞大。
It seems like they are making the small matters big.
但是在小事上忠心，却会被神大大的使用。
But if one is faithful in the small things, God will use them mightily.
今天如果你在职场上，你的老板叫你讲一个小小的谎言
，If your boss actually asks you to make a white lie, a small lie,
你会怎么做呢
？What would you do？
那我们再看就是接下来他就求太监长容他不玷污自己。
And therefore, in the following verse, it says, therefore he requested of the chief of the eunuchs that he might not defile himself.
即使要抗议，也要带着一个的谦卑的态度，就是一个的客气、有礼貌、谦和、温柔的口吻。
Even though they wanted to object, but they objected with humility and wisdom.
如果你平时有良好的态度，
if you always have a good attitude,
到了有事相求的时候，
when there's something that you need to request,
你的老板也会比较谅解，不会善待你。
And your boss will be more gentle and will treat you better.
你要持守原则呢，也不需要摆出一副斗公鸡的样子。
Even though you want to hold on to your principles, but you do not have to act it out in a defensive manner.
而且他们有智慧，就是懂得衡量。
They had wisdom to actually evaluate.
他知道在正确的时机说正确的话，做正确的事。
They knew what is the right time to do and say the right thing.
他说：“我不绝对不玷污自己，死就死吧。”
I will definitely not defile myself, whether or not I will die.
但是如果有选择可以不死的话，就最好别死。
Of course, if there's a choice, we want to live, right?
因为神也不一定要他们成为殉道者。
Because God probably doesn't want them to become martyr.
当然神要我们把他放在生命的首位。
Of course God wants us to put him in the first priority in our life.
但是他也没有要求我们一定就是面对苦难。
But he does not ask us to ordain that we must go through trials or suffering.
除非不可避免的时候。
Unless it's necessary.
如果没有智慧呢，我们就以为只有两条路。
So if we do not have wisdom, then we probably think there are only two roads laid before us.
就是 do or die.
Do or 做或者是死。
不然要不就得罪神，要不就得罪王，赔上生命。
One is to offend God, and another one is to offend the king and then die.
啊，但是但以理他有智慧。
But Daniel had wisdom.
在抗议之前，想想有没有两全其美的方式，还有没有第三条路
？Before he objected, he was actually trying to find a third alternative that is better.
他以婉言相求太监长。不容他玷污自己。
He also requested of the chief of the eunuchs that he might not defile himself in a gentle manner.
他既没有得罪神、违背神，也没有违背王。
He did not offend the God and also did not offend the king.
他没有盲从王的命令，但是他却没有挑战权柄。
He did not, you know, obey the king blindly, but he also did not challenge his throne.
这也是主耶稣基督的教导。
So this is also the teaching of Jesus.
他说现在我差派你们出去就是进入世界去影响世界。
So I'm sending you out into the world to influence the world.
你们就好像羊进入狼群的中间，所以你们要像石一样的寂静，像鸽子一样的纯洁。
You're going out like sheep among wolves, therefore be as shrewd as snakes and as innocent as doves.
要灵巧相识，孙良如鸽子。
As shrewd as snakes and as innocent as doves.
然后保罗呢也有教导说在罗马书的十二章十节他说你们不可以恶报恶大家以为美的事要努力去做可能的话总要尽你们所能的与人和睦
So Paul also has this teaching in Romans chapter 12 it says do not repay evil for evil respect what is right in the sight of all men if possible so far as it depends on you be at peace with all men
我们看到但以理勇敢决定了结果呢就是神叫他在权柄人士的面前蒙恩惠
So we can see the outcome or results of Daniel's courageous decision was God gave Daniel favor and goodwill with the authorities.
接下来我们看在第九节第十节，神使但以理在太监长眼前蒙恩惠，受怜悯。
Yeah, so God actually granted Daniel favor and compassion before the commander of officials.
太监长对但以理说：“我惧怕我主我王，他已经派定你们的饮食。
For he has appointed your food and drink.”
倘若他见你们的面貌比你们同岁的少年人肌瘦怎么好呢？这样你们就使我的头在王那里难保。
But why should he see your faces looking more haggard than the youths who are your own age? Then you would make me forfeit my head to the king.
但以理他们决定信靠神，神就没有丢弃他们。
Daniel decided to trust in God, hence God did not forsake them.
神使他们在太监长的面前蒙恩惠，受怜悯。
God granted Daniel favor and compassion before the commander of the officials.
若不是神帮助他们，太监长绝对没有任何帮助他们的理由，为他们冒着生命的危险。
If God wasn't for Daniel, the chief of eunuchs wouldn't have risked his life for them.
但是但以理他们做出合理的要求，他们有智慧。
But Daniel made a reasonable request, and it was wise.
你看，神可以使用地上的权柄人士去帮助那些信靠他的人。
So God could actually use a worldly authority to help those who trust in Him.
但是神也因着但以理聪慧的举动而使他领受这个恩典。
But also because of the wise decisions from Daniel, hence Daniel successfully received the blessing from God.
但是但以理他也明白太监长的难处。
But Daniel understood the difficulties of the chief of eunuchs as well.
他没有要求别人承担他自己的后果。
He did not request others to be responsible for the consequences of his decision.
他愿意让他自己对神的信心得到考验。
He was willing to allow his faith in God to be tested.
于是他就提出了一个很聪明的妥协。
As he requested,For a very wise compromise.
一个没有违背神的妥协。
A compromise that does not offend God.
正如在雅各书的第三章十五节到十七节这里说呢，这种智慧不是从天上来的，而是属地的、属血气的和属鬼魔的。因为凡有嫉妒和自私的地方，就必有扰乱和各样的坏事。
So such wisdom does not come down from heaven, but is earthly, unspiritual of the devil. For where you have envy and selfish ambition, there you find disorder and every evil practice.
至于从天上来的智慧首先是纯洁的其次是和平的温柔的谦顺的满有恩慈和善果没有偏袒没有虚伪
But the wisdom that comes from heaven is first of all pure then peace loving considerate submissive full of mercy and good fruit impartial and sincere
雅各书告诉我们呢，在地上的智慧是属血气的属世界的智慧
So in the book of James it says wisdomOn earth is actually earthly and spiritual of the devil.
所以我们必须活在世上的时候，需要从神领受那属天的智慧。
So when we live on earth, we have to receive the wisdom from heaven.
有些时候呢，当我们要为主的话语站立的时候，是无可避免的，要为主受苦，要为主受逼迫的。
So when we stand firm on God's word, there would be a necessity for us to go through trials.
但是也不一定是如此的。有些时候呢，神也帮助我们去脱离世上的愁事跟逼迫。
But it might not definitely be the case. Sometimes God will help us to overcome these trials and sufferings.
除非是无可避免的时候。
Unless it's out of no choice.
我们只需要选择做对的事，后果我们就完全的交给神。
As long as we choose to do the right thing, then we leave the consequences in God's hand.
太监长虽然同情但是给他们。
The chief of eunuchs, even though he actually had compassion on Daniel and his friends.
但是他也有自己的苦衷，他担心他们不吃肉会面亡肌瘦。不健康，怎样可以向王去交代呢？
But he also had his concern. He was worried that if they look haggard or more haggard and less healthy than the young youth of their age, then how can he be accountable to God?
然后他已经对他说：“求你施施仆人们十天，给我们素菜吃，白水喝，然后看看我们的面貌和用王上的那些少年的面貌，就照你所看待你所看的待仆人吧。”
So please let your servants for 10 days let us be given some vegetables to eat and water to drink, then let our appearance be observed in your presence and the appearance of the youths who are eating the king's choice food and deal with your servants according to what you see.
我们看到丹尼里他们不但只有原则有勇气有良好的态度，他们也有很好的建议。
We can see that Daniel and his friends, they did not just uphold principles, they were not just courageous, excellent attitude, but they also had good suggestions.
今天他们在职场上工作的时候，如果你对上司的看法他的做法不同意的时候，
When you're working in the marketplace, if you're not in an agreement with your boss's decision or action,
会不会用一个很良好的态度勇于去表达？
Would you use a good attitude to proactively give your good suggestion?
但是你必须要提出一个良好的建议。
But the criteria is that you have to give a good suggestion.
你不能够只是说这里不好那边不好，这里有问题那里有问题。
You cannot just command that this is not good, that is bad.
你的责任就是去想办法去建议去解决问题。
Your responsibility is actually to give good suggestions and to solve problems.
不然请你做啥？
If not, how, why would the company hire you?
你看丹尼里他也有信心。
Daniel had this faith as well.
他相信神会因着他们的顺服他们的祷告帮助他们使他们健康。
He believed that God would help them to be healthy out of their obedience to him.
他知道他们的信心是经得起考验的。
He knew that their faith can be tested.
第十四节，委办便允准他们这些事，试探他们十天。
So he listened to them in this matter and tested them for 10 days.
过了十天，见他们的面貌比用王山的一些少年人更加俊美肥胖。
At the end of 10 days, their appearance seemed better, and they were fatter than all the youths who had been eating the king's choice food.
于是委办吃去派他们用的三饮的酒给他们蔬菜吃。
So the overseer continued to withhold their choice food and the wine they were to drink and kept giving them vegetables.
你看丹尼里他们完全没有讨价还价的条件，而他们不能够做决定。
So Daniel actually did not have the stand to negotiate or decide.
但是神却让他们的要求得到允准。
But God allowed their request to be approved.
你看一个人不吃肉只吃菜，要均美肥胖已经不容易了。
So if one is only living on vegetables, in order to be, you know, looking good and fat, it's not easy.
这里讲到他们甚至比别的用王山的少年人还更加的俊美肥胖。
But here it says their appearance is better and they were fatter than all the youths who had been eating the king's choice food.
他们只是吃蔬菜，他们只是喝开水。
They were only living on vegetables and water.
因为有吃 ice cream, burnt cheesecake.
They did not take ice cream or burnt cheesecake.
但是他们居然比别人还俊美肥胖。
But they look better and were fatter than the youth of their age.
你看信靠神的人就不一样。
So people who trust in the Lord are different.
我们教会的年轻人啊，比外面的年轻人都好看很多。
So our youth actually look better than the youth out there.
我想大家都认同这一点。
I believe all of you would agree with me on this point.
他们都有很高的颜值。
They have a high value in their appearance.
不是俊美就是肥胖。
Not handsome and then it would be...
然后他们顺服呢，就是他们蒙福与高升的原因。
So, yeah, obedience was the cause of the blessedness and promotion.
十七节，这四个少年人，神在各样文学或者智慧上赐给他们聪明知识，但以理又明白各样的异象和梦兆。
As for these youths, God gave them knowledge and intelligence in every branch of literature and wisdom. Daniel even understood all kinds of visions and dreams.
尼布加尼撒王预定带进少年人来的日期满了，三年过后了，太监长就把他们带到王的面前。
Then at the end of the days which the king had specified for presenting them, which is 3 years, the commander of the officials presented them before Nebuchadnezzar.
王与他们谈论，见少年人中无一人比但以理、哈拿利亚、米撒里、亚撒里亚，除了留他们在王面前侍立。王拷问他们一切的事，究竟他们的智慧聪明，比通国的术士和用法术的胜过十倍。
The king talked with them, and out of them, not one was found like Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. So they entered the king's personal service. As for every matter of wisdom and understanding about which the king consulted them, he found them 10 times better than all the magicians and conjurers who were in his realm.
神赐他们聪明智慧。
God gave them wisdom and understanding.
他们不只是样貌俊美，而且呢是聪明绝顶。
They were not just looking good on the outside, but they were so knowledgeable.
所以都教你们要多吃菜。
So I ask you to take more vegetables.
当然这不是吃菜的原因，而是他们对神的顺服。
Of course, this was not a matter of taking vegetables, but their obedience to God.
大大的顺服就大大的蒙福。
When they were greatly obedient, then they were greatly blessed.
神也让他们明白各样的异象和梦兆。
God also allowed them to understand all visions.
就是有属天的智慧，有属灵的洞察力。
Having spiritual wisdom and understanding
是超越世上的智慧。
All this wisdom is supersede all the earthly wisdom.
唯有清心的人得以见上帝，唯有忠心的人呢，会神会大大的使用。
So for the pure at heart, they will see God, and for those who are faithful, they will be used mightily by God.
他们生在巴比伦，却不属于巴比伦，胜过巴比伦。
They live in Babylonia, but they overcame the Babylonian culture.
他们在地上的国度，却彰显天上国度的能力、智慧和尊荣耀。
Even though they were living under the earthly kingdom, but they were living out the spiritual king, heavenly kingdom.
他们虽然处在世界上的文化这个政治的局势当中，但是神却兴起他们发挥影响力。
Even though they were living on earthly culture under the human political culture, but they were subjected to God's authority.
他们没有被同化，他们被神兴起影响这个世界。
They were not assimilated by the worldly culture, but they raised and be a light to the world.
他们学习了这个世上的文化和知识，但是他们却通过神给他们的属天的智慧去应用这些知识。
So they learned the earthly knowledge and information, but they used God's wisdom to use this knowledge wisely.
他们得到卓越的成就，使到神的名得尊荣。
They had outstanding achievements in a way to honor God.
那些被掳的少年人当中，当然不只是他们几个。
Of course, there were many youths who were captivated, not just 4 of them.
但其他的都去了哪里了？圣经连他们的名字提也没有提到。
But all the rest, the Bible did not mention their name, not even one of them.
只有但以理和他三个朋友呢，他们对主忠心，坚守原则，就是靠主得胜到底。
Only Daniel and his 3 friends, they held on to the biblical principles and they decided to follow God to the end.
最后21节，到古列王元年，但以理还在。
And finally, and Daniel continued until the first year of Cyrus the king.
古列王已经是波斯的君王。
So Cyrus was actually the king of Persia.
你看，但以理呢，他经过了几朝的改朝换代，从犹大的王朝越亚境的时候他被掳。
So during the king of Jehoiakim, Judean dynasty, he was captivated.
然后去到巴比伦的王朝，就是尼布加尼撒，后来到波沙沙做王。
And then he went through the Babylonian dynasty, which was led by the Nebuchadnezzar, and then it was the Darius Cyrus.
巴比伦王朝被波斯马代灭了之后呢，就是到大利物。古列塞鲁士的王朝。
Yeah, and before that, it was Media Persian dynasty.
但以理他们从世界的学校毕业之后，他们就不断的被主训练。
So after they graduated from the earthly schools and education, they were constantly trained by God.
他们从门徒被提升为门训者。
So they raised from being disciples to disciples.
他们活在一个的动荡的一个的时代。
They live in a turbulent era.
他们大半的连日都是在外邦人的管制之下。
Most of the days of their lives, they were living under the authority of the Gentiles.
但是他们却取得耀眼亮丽的成就。
But they have made great and outstanding achievements.
他们内在的信念，他们内在的力量胜过外在的压力。
The power or strength from within them is actually greater than force outside.
他们因为敬畏神被神提升，被神提拔。
Because of their obedience to God, they were promoted by God.
而且我们也看到一个的信仰群体的重要。
We also saw the importance of belief in a congregation.
然后我们看到这帮的年轻人，他们在这个的外邦的压力，这个的世界的诱惑当中，他们彼此守望，彼此鼓励，一起坚守神的原则。
We also saw that even they were living in a world that's against God's culture, they were living and supporting each other in their belief in God.
他们一起来见证神的荣耀，一起活出美好的生命。
Together they witness to the glory of God and they live outGod's honor.
今天不管我们是在犹大或巴比伦，
whether we are in the Judah dynasty or Babylon,
在教会或世界，在职场，
whether in the church or in the marketplace or the world,
在顺境或逆境的当中，
whether in good or bad times,
我们相信神依然掌权，他坐在宝座上。
We trust that God still reigns and He is enthroned in His.
不管环境如何，
no matter what is the circumstance,
我们相信神依然是信实的，我们可以信靠他。
We trust that God is still faithful and we can trust in Him.
但他也期待我们对他全然的顺服，全然的信靠。
Of course, He is also requiring our full obedience and dependence on Him.
这也是我们对下一代的希望。
This is also our hope for our next generation.
靠主站立，靠主得胜。
To stand through God and to overcome through God.
坚持到底。
And hold on to the end.
我们一起来祷告。
Let us all pray.
天父，我们感谢你，因为你是信实可靠的神。
Our Father, we thank you for you are a faithful God.
在这个邪恶的时代的当中，主啊，你恩待我们。
In this evil world, Lord, you have granted us favor.
你带领我们走过一切的苦难，一切的挑战。
You have led us through all trials and sufferings.
当我们定睛仰望你的时候，
as we fix our eyes on you,
主，你赐给我们那属天的智慧。
You have given us spiritual wisdom.
那胜过世界的智慧。
The wisdom to overcome the world.
赐给我们勇气。
To give us courage.
叫我们立定心志，坚定依靠你。
And help us to be convicted to follow you to the end.
叫我们不玷污自己，叫我们分别为圣。
That we will not defile ourselves and we will consecrate ourselves.
把我们的下一代全然的交托。
We commit and surrender our next generation.
主，是你亲自来呼召拣选他们。
You have personally called and chosen them.
你就会保守他们到底。
And you will protect them to the end.
求你兴起上一代的父老去守望他们，去帮助他们，去教导他们。
Lord, please raise up leaders from the earlier generation to lead them and guide them.
愿意超越世代的局限。去造就他们做主的门徒，
to be able to cross the generational line to be their disciples，
好叫他们世世代代延续神你的使命，
so that they will continue to hold on to your mission，
直到主耶稣你再来的日子，
until the day you return。
我们如此祷告感恩，奉告主耶稣基督的名，
we pray and give thanks in the name of Jesus。
Amen.
Amen.
好，谢谢大家，主赐福大家。
Thank you everyone. God bless all of you.
再见。
See you again.
Shout it out. Pushing